Welcome back, basic drawing students. We are on to page 3 in our packet. It looks like this, and it's just a continuation of what we did yesterday with the basic line drawings to create the illusion of depth. So we're going to continue that in this box below. So it says to copy the simple forms into the box below just as you see it. You can make them a little bit bigger, but not too big, or else it's not going to fit in your rectangle. When you are done with that, you are going to move on to the next type of line drawings called blind contour. This is really fun. Blind contour lines are created by drawing without picking up your pencil and by not looking at the paper while you draw. This is very hard to do for a lot of people, especially those of us that draw a lot, because you're constantly looking at the paper. You're hardly looking at the thing that you're drawing, which is a mistake. Let's say you want to draw this light bulb, and if you are not paying attention, you're going to miss little things like this little weird divot thing that's corroded on the side here, or how the shadows play right here is the highlight and the shadows play this way and this way off of the bottom metal piece, or how about the reflections of the ceiling lights above me on this part of the light bulb, and it kind of curves around so it looks like it's a 3D form. So you would miss a lot if you weren't paying much attention to the object that you're drawing. So blind contour line drawings are fun to do and make us really pay attention to the thing that we're trying to draw. So there are some examples of blind contour drawings, and these artists created them just without looking at their paper. But if you have a problem doing that without looking, then I suggest taking a piece of blank paper and putting your hand underneath it so you can't see what you're drawing. The other way is to use a paper bag and open the bag up, put your paper inside that you're drawing on, and then put your hand inside so you cannot see. You know those forms that we had that covered the keyboards in middle school, the box tops? That would be another good thing to have to do these with. So these artists all created their own, so I'm just interested to see what you think that they are. So look at each one and try to figure out what they were trying to draw, and then just label it below each drawing, each four of these drawings. Some of them are a little bit easier than others to figure out. When you're done with that, now it's your turn to do some blind contour drawings. So the things to keep in mind: you don't look at the paper, you only look at the thing you're drawing. You do not erase anything, and you never pick your pencil up. So it's a continuous line that never stops, okay? So you're gonna choose objects that you have with you or that I supplied at the table for you, depending if you're virtual or not. So using blind contour lines, do not pick up your pencil. Draw each object. I will have four different ones for you to draw on the following four blank pages. The first object should be drawn on this page. So I want you to label it and tell us what you're drawing a picture of. And then you're gonna draw it number one, number two, number three will go here, and then the fourth object here. If you are at home, please choose objects that are different and that are not too basic. Like an orange is too basic. I keep going back to that example, but it's true, okay? So once that is done, you are done for your lesson today. Have fun.